Sri Gurupyo Namaha children, welcome to Online Teaching Academy Ekalaiva. Class 11 Business Studies, Lesson 4 Business Services. In this session we are going to see about banking services. So what is banking? A bank is a financial institution which provides institutional credit to its customers. So a bank accepts money on deposits, repayable on demand, and also earns a margin of profit by lending money. So a bank accepts money on deposits. So bank accepts money from the people in the form of deposits, and these deposits are repayable. Whenever the customer wants to withdraw money, he can withdraw it from the bank account. So it is repayable on demand by the customer, and also the bank earns a margin of profit by lending money. That is, the deposits accepted from the people are assembled or mobilized. That is, the savings of the people are mobilized, and these funds are made available to the people as loans and advances. This function is done by the bank. So the bank mobilizes the savings of the people and makes funds available to business by financing their capital and revenue expenditure. So banks accepts deposits which is repayable on demand, and those deposits from the people which are accepted by the banks are mobilized, and they are used for providing loans and advances to the people who are in need of it. It also deals in financial instruments and provides financial services for a price. So for providing these services, that is for accepting deposits and lending money, they charge a price called interest, discount and commission, etc. We will see about the types of banks. So it can be classified into commercial banks, cooperative banks, specialized banks and central banks. So what is a commercial bank? These are institutions dealing in money. So these banks are governed by Indian Banking Regulation Act 1949. That is, these banks function according to the guidelines by the Indian Banking Regulation Act 1949. According to Indian Banking Regulation Act 1949, a commercial bank accepts deposits of money from the public for the purpose of lending or investment. So they accept deposits, and those deposits of money are mobilized and they are provided to the people as loans and advances. The two types of commercial banks are public sector banks and private sector banks. So under public sector banks, the government has major stake in the public sector banks, and they function for social objective than profit earning. Private sector banks are owned, controlled and managed by the private promoters. Public sector banks, you can say the example of State Bank of India, Indian Overseas Bank, Punjab National Bank, etc. Private sector banks, you can say the example as Kotak Mahindra Bank, Lakshmi Vilas Bank, ICICA Bank, Jammu and Kashmir Bank, etc. Then we will move on to cooperative banks. Another classification of bank is cooperative banks. These banks are governed by the provisions of State Cooperative Societies Act. These banks provide cheap credit to their members. It is an important source of rural credit, especially in the case of agricultural sectors. And another classification of bank is a specialized bank. So from the name itself we can understand these banks are established for the to fulfill the specific needs of the people. So So these banks are foreign exchange banks, industrial banks, development banks, export-import banks, catering to specific needs of these unique activities. They are established to fulfill the specific needs. For example, if these banks can provide financial assistance to industries and assistance for foreign trade, and even they can provide financial assistance for the heavy turnkey projects, etc. So, to fulfill the specific needs, these banks are created. And then, central bank. So, the central bank of any country supervises, controls, and regulates the activities of all commercial banks. So, the central bank of any country, it regulates the activities of all the commercial banks of that country. And it also acts as a government banker. So our Central Bank of India is the Reserve Bank of India. It controls and coordinates currency. So it controls and regulates the issue of currency. And even it regulates the credit policy of our country also. So the Reserve Bank regulates the credit policy of our country. So this is our central bank of our country. The Reserve Bank of India is our central bank. Then what are the functions of commercial banks? Acceptance of deposits, lending of funds, check facility, remittance of funds, allied services. These are all the functions of commercial banks. What is this acceptance of deposits? So deposits accepted from the people are the basis for providing loans. Since banks act here, both borrowers and lenders of money, when they accept the deposits from the people, they act as a borrower. When they provide loans to the people, they act as a lender. So, for these services, they are charging certain rate of interest when they lend money, and when they borrow money, that is when they accept deposits from the people, they pay a rate of interest. So, these interest rates are decided by the RBI, Reserve Bank of India. So, as borrowers, they pay interest. As lenders, they get interest. So, as lenders, they get interest. As borrowers, they pay interest. Deposits are generally taken through current account, savings account, and fixed deposits. Current account deposits can be withdrawn to the extent of the balance at any time without any prior notice. This is the advantage in current account deposits. These are usually maintained by the business people because at any time they can go and withdraw their fund from their account. And savings accounts are for encouraging savings by individuals. So to mobilize, to encourage the habit of saving among the people, these savings accounts are maintained by the banks. Individuals can open the savings account and deposit their money in their savings account. Banks pay rate of interest as decided by RBI on these deposits. So the rate of interest is decided by RBI. Rate of interest is decided by the Reserve Bank of India, which is our central bank. And another type of account is fixed accounts. Fixed accounts are time deposits. That is, for a particular period of time, our money will be deposited in the fixed accounts. It may be for 45 days or for 6 months or 1 year or 5 years or 10 years. It is our wish to fix the date, fix the time. So, fixed accounts are time deposits with higher rate of interest because our money is kept with a bank for a long time. We are not withdrawing then and there as we do in savings account. That is why the rate of interest will be higher when it is compared to the savings account. Sometimes premature withdrawal is also permissible in case of fixed accounts, but we have to pay certain rate of interest for getting the money before the maturity date. This is allowed in case of fixed accounts. And another function of a commercial bank is lending of funds. That is lending loans and advances, providing loans and advances out of the money received through deposits. These advances can be made in the form of overdraft. That is, overdraft means overdrawn from the account. Even the balance, that is, you can draw more than the balance which is maintained in your account. This is called overdraft. Cash credit is a kind of short-term loan provided by the banks on getting some credit worthiness from the customers. And discounting trade bills and consumer credits are provided by the banks. Then check facility is given by the banks to the consumers. What is a check? It is a document that orders the bank to pay a sum of money from the customer's account to the person on whom the check is issued. This is called a check. So banks render a service to their customers by collecting their checks drawn on their banks. It is the most convenient and an inexpensive medium of exchange. So there are two types of checks, mainly bearer check, which are encashable immediately at the bank counters. You can see the sample of bearer checks given here. This is a bearer check. See, you can see here you have to write the date, month and the year, and you have to pay, that is, for whom you are issuing this check. Their name has to be mentioned, or even pay self. You can draw money using this check also, and you have to enter the rupees here, and you have to put your signature, and you can present this check in the counter of the bank, and you will be paid money on receiving the check by the banker. This is a bearer check. And crossed check, which are to be deposited only in the payee's account. So this is the sample of crossed check. So here you can see in the left hand corner of a check, two lines have to be drawn, and in between you have to write account payee. This means the money goes to a bank account only, and it will not be encashed at the counter. That is, the amount will be deposited only in the payee's account. That is, to whom the check is issued, in that party's account only the money will be credited. Okay, it will not be given in the counter. The cash won't be given in the counter. The amount will be credited in the payee's account. So, crossed checks which are to be deposited only in the payee's account. This is a specimen of crossed check. You can see two lines in the left corner of the check, and it is written account payee. That means the amount will be deposited only in the account, payee's account. Okay. You cannot present this check in the counter and get the money in your hand. It will be deposited in the payee's account. This is the difference between, it is always safe to cross the check, because definitely in that payee's account only the amount will be deposited. If it is a bearer check, if it is missed, means anybody can present the bearer check and get the money from the bank. If you cross it, means in that particular account only the amount will be deposited. And then what is remittance of funds? It means funds, transfer of funds or sending of funds. Okay, this facility is also provided by the bank. So this facility of fund transfer from one place to another on account of the interconnectivity of branches. That is, fund may be transferred from one branch of a bank to another branch of the same bank, and the bank issues a draft for the amount on its own branches at other places or other banks at those places. The payee can present the draft on the drawee bank at his place and collect the amount. That is, the payee means the person who has to receive the money can present the draft on the drawee bank, that is the bank which provides the money to the payee, at his place itself and collect the amount. And some other allied services are also provided by the bank other than acceptance of deposits and lending of money. These services are also provided by the bank, such as bill payments, locker facilities, that is, we can keep our valuables, jewelries, etc. in the lockers provided by the banks. For that, they will charge a certain amount of money for keeping our valuables in their lockers. And they perform services like buying and selling of shares and debentures on instructions. So, shares may be bought and sold with the help of banks. And other personal services like payment of insurance premium. We can pay our insurance premium and we can collect our dividend through the banks. And we have come to the e-banking. That is, e-banking means banking transactions done through electronic medium. So, e-banking is nothing but electronic banking. So, customers can conduct banking transactions over the internet. So, it avoids crowding in the bank. We need not stand in a queue for a long time in the banks. Instead, we can use this e-banking facility and we can sit at our home or during traveling or during night times also, we can access the banking transactions by e-bank. So, it provides 24 hours, 365 days a year services to the customers. And load on branches, that is workload on branches, can be reduced by establishing centralized data bank. Customers can make some of the permitted transactions from anywhere. This is the great advantage provided by e-banking facility. So, we have come to the end of this session, children. To receive the online lessons, subscribe our YouTube channel. Press the subscribe button. You will be getting the latest updated videos. Thank you, children. We will meet in the next class.